So years ago, I used to work at Family Video in Springfield, Illinois. This was back in 1995. I worked there for about a year and a half. And I mention this because this place was probably a key part in what has led to my interest in watching old films, particularly these old films of the past that I go looking for. Family Video was an okay employer. I worked mostly second shift. It could be anywhere from like noon to late at night. You didn't get any breaks, you're often alone, and you have to deal with plenty of customer interaction, including proto-Karens and people who are just lingering around waiting for somebody to have returned the latest copy of First Night. And this was an interesting era, you know, the 1990s, everything was VHS at that point, and this was a shop that would get, you know, 80 to 100 copies of the latest blockbuster, which at that time would be films like Jumanji, Congo, Judge Dredd, Major Payne, Braveheart. I mean, it was just a strange time for cinema. And, you know, people would show up. They didn't have a card. They would just use their driver's license or a phone number. And it was $2.50 for one night, $3 two nights. And you could get a free classic rental with a new release. Or a free head cleaner. Yeah, good times. And, you know, I didn't mind working there. It was kind of fun. And, you know, I would rent tons of movies during my time then. Not just renting movies to bring them home, but I'd be watching them in the store as well. It was at this point I really started to appreciate some of the older classics of the past. I started watching old Orson Welles movies, starting with, like, Citizen Kane. But then I watched Touch of Evil from 1958. Really enjoyed that. Humphrey Bogart became one of my favorite actors. I saw him in Casablanca, of course, and many other films. And I also started to really appreciate Alfred Hitchcock at that time. And I still have not seen every Hitchcock film made, but in that time frame, I was enjoying his films of the 50s. Movies like To Catch a Thief and Rear Window. And Family Video also did a fairly decent job of carrying foreign titles, and that was my introduction to films with, say, Toshiro Mifune, films like Seven Samurai, Yojimbo, Throne of Blood, and various samurai movies as well. And that, of course, led to Akira Kurosawa films like Hidden Fortress. I love those Star Wars elements. Ran, Kajimusha, Rashomon, High and Low, and even the movie Dreams, which is pretty trippy, but I still enjoy it anyway. And I also watched, you know, some French films, like there was a version of Les Miserables that came out in 1995. This isn't the Hugh Jackman version. And, you know, it's like looking in hindsight, I wish I could get back to a list of everything I rented back in the 90s. It's probably all lost, but it would be neat to get this and kind of incorporate this into my growing list of films that I still want to watch and review for my channel. So anyhow, those are just some thoughts about Family Video. I mean, it played a big part in my interest in watching old movies. And it's a shame that, you know, the traditional video stores aren't really around anymore. I know it's a kind of a weird way to think about looking for films by going into stores and then looking at those ad boxes and kind of basing your judgment on that. It's a weird time. You know, now you can just like put on Netflix or Amazon, watch a trailer and get an idea of what the film's about and then just instantly stream. But, you know, I kind of miss those days of the old fashioned video store. And I kind of miss VHS tapes too in a weird way, even though they did have a tendency to tangle and snap. So, all right, maybe they weren't that great, but it's just nostalgia.